is what it isn't. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Me get up, first shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby's for the game. Nope, nope, y'all can't copy yet. Bad moonwalking, and this here is our party. My posse's been on Broadway, and we did it all way. Chrome music, I shed my skin and put my bones into everything I record to it. And yeah, I'm on. Let that stage light go and shine on down. Got that Bob Barker suit game and Plinko in my style. Money, stay on my craft and stick around for those pounds. But I do that to pass the torch and put on for my town. Trust me, on my I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T shit hustling. Chasing dreams since I was 14 with the four-track busting. Halfway across that city with the back.
My name is Timothy Henderson, and one thing that I want to get out of this program is to build my networking, to be able to go to different environments and see how they work with machines.
My name is Corey Griffiths, and what I want to get out of this program is resilience.
Hi, my name is Brandon Allister, and what I want to learn to get out of this program is work with others.
So let me show you guys.
Kenesha Station. Well, I'll show you, I guess, all the stations. So this is kind of where we wrap soaps. And this is one of the handmade things that we do. Let me just see if I can show you these boxes. So basically, before we used to have these soaps in a little naked wrapper, but let me show you this. So people like you go to school in manufacturing to figure out better ways to do things. This box was a better way to sell the soap. Sometimes we have that word, no packaging. But basically I designed this box. And it was funny because our old soaps, they just had like a little piece of paper. You see that sometimes like in Whole Foods or some of the health food stores have a little piece of paper on it. And even though the soap is the same soap, we sell so much more soap now that it's in better packaging. Like I said, people go to school just to figure out how to package things.
Any more questions for
me? You can say that a lot. Or I'm
looking, this stuff, this is fairly new. We do a pretty good job at, with it. It comes in off the truck every day. So that's me being logistics. My job is to make sure the ports for me. If anything that comes in the store, I'm responsible for it. And if it comes off the truck every day, it means somebody's buying it. So my best guess would be yes. We do a pretty good job at selling it. So you see we only got one up on the floor now. So and we actually this whole entire section thing is pretty light. It's a gift and a curse. If it's light, that means people are buying it. But unfortunately, we're not getting enough in the store to finish it. So that's when I would probably reach out, reset the accumulator, call the DC and let them know, hey, we need more of this product. Or just flat out do more research on it to get it into the actual store.
Hello, my name is Christian Abihe, and what I hope to get out of this summer program is to make connections with our manufacturing companies.
Hello, my name is Devontae Taylor. The thing I'm trying to get out of this summer program is learning how to speak fluently and better, and learn how to do things that might benefit my future.
Hello, my name is Larry Brewer, and one of the things I want to get and learn from out of this Manufacturing Connect program is to talk more discreetly and have more fluently skills. And by doing that, is taking my time with my words.
Hello, my name is Devontae Taylor, and we just walked in at Prosier Airbrush, and we're finna take a look around how they make airbrushes.
Okay, we manufacture artist airbrushes, and we also make industrial spray guns and spray booths as well.
So which one is most popular?
The most popular is our artist airbrush, and our H airbrush and our BL airbrush are the oldest ones that we've been making and are very, very popular. We call them the workhorses of the airbrush market.
So they're the most popular because they've been around the longest?
Because they're very sturdy. People don't have problems with them. They hold up. They're made out of brass, so you know they're not ever going to wear out. They just have to replace some of the parts, the needles and the air caps and the tips.
So were the paintings in this room made with the airbrush you made this company?
They were, all except for one. The one of Mr. Pasci is not. It's not an airbrush. Everything else is.
So how long has this company been around?
Since 1904.
And you're proud of it?
Very proud of that.
So are you like directly related to the person who owned the company?
The person that started the company was my husband's grandfather.
Right now I'm doing a setup for a new breed. So we gotta put the tools in, line them up, touch them, run it slow the first couple of times to make sure that everything in the program is okay. After that, I just go around each machine, check the pieces, make sure that all the provisions are in place. And daily, that's really what I'm doing.
So since you started, how many promotions have you got?
Five.
So when you started, where were you?
Well, okay, promotions, okay. Okay, but that's different, that's different. Promotions, I'd probably say one. I went from an operator to CNC, machine and operator to CNC operator. So you can say one, I thought you meant crazy.
Okay, so do you enjoy your job here?
Yeah, I look forward to coming every day.
Because we look forward to having you here. And he never misses a day. He's always on time. He's a good employee.
We are not leaving Pagier Airbrush. The most was how Ms. Pedersen treated us, how they made sculptures, airbrush shirts, jackets, and how we met a former Austin Polytechnical student, Raheem Buford, who is going to meet with us next Thursday. Yeah.
Hello, my name is Diamond Smith. Out of this program, I would like to learn more communication skills and watching engineering work hands-on.
Hi, my name is Antoine Revin. And out of this program, I want to gain the ability to enhance my communication skills and see how engineers operate machines.
Okay. My name is Shalona Bihe. And what I plan to get out of this program is learn to communicate with others effectively and efficiently so I can work collectively towards a goal with my partners.
My name is Devin Hughes, and out of this program, I want to have the ability to talk to people I don't know. And in the machine shop, I want to learn how engineers put together the pieces that they make.
Our project is to make heart-shaped paintings for Ms. Diaz. The first step is to cut a brass piece 2x2.
There you go. Now,
okay.
Once the raw material is machined completely, it will look like this.
This is step 3 of the process. And during this process,
we got to foul this piece right here. The reason we got to foul it is because as they come out the CNC machine, the edge of the piece be real sharp, and if we don't foul it, the customer could cut themselves on the piece, so after we foul it, it's going to be more smooth.
We scrape some of the paint off with some steel wool to make you see the picture clearer. And this is the finished product.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. The system broken, the schools closed, the prisons open. We ain't got nothing to lose, everybody we rolling. Everybody we rolling. With some light-skinned girls and some Kelly Rollins. And this white man world, we the ones chosen. So good night, cool world, I see you in the morning. I see you in the morning. I need a moment.